Rajeshwari MG. She pursued her BE in Electrical and Electronics at the People's Education Society College of Engineering, Mandya. She pursued her M.Tech in VLSI Design and Embedded Systems at the Sri Jagadguru Balagangadharanta Institute of Technology, Bangalore. Her personal skills lie in good verbal and written communication skills. Her areas of interest lie in OOPS with C++, renewable energy sources, HVDC transmission, digital relays, automotive electronics, advances in VLSI design. She has also had papers presented at the national level, such as the innovative architecture for SoC multi-core hybrid processor, presented at the RNSIT Bangalore.
Welcome to UGC lecture series of BSc Applied Electronics. Today we are dealing with the subject Television and Engineering. This is the most interesting subject. Today we are going to start with the Unit 1. The contents in the Unit 1 that we are going to discuss are Introduction to Television and Evolution of TV, some of the definition of TV engineering, elements of TV systems. That is a Unit 1 topic. So, in the elements of TV system, there are different elements of a TV system. That one topic we are going to cover in this session, that is picture transmission, and the remaining one are sound transmission, picture reception, sound reception, synchronization, receiver controls, and the last one is a color television. These all are called as the element of TV system. If we call a TV system, means all these things should include in a TV system. So, let us start with the first topic, that is the first we need to know the introduction. Let us start how the TV is evolved, how when it is invented, what are the changes made in which year. Let us start with the very first slide, introduction to television. The word television, it has two Greek word. Tele in the sense at distance, vision means seeing. So, television helps us to see at distance pictures, that we are able to see a picture sitting in front of a TV, we can able to see a picture that is very far from our eye. So, this makes us a sense of seeing the picture that is can't able to see naturally with our eye, that is why it is called as television. Earlier, selenium photosensitive cells were used for converting light from pictures into electrical. This is what the technique that they are going to use in earlier days. Selenium photosensitive cells are going to use for converting optical signals into electrical signals. Next, it is evolved as the first camera tube, that is iconoscope, came into picture when the selenium is used as a photosensitive material. After that, the evolution starts, and after that, the first camera tube called iconoscope. Camera tube will be at a transmitter part. So, that is what we call as a camera, generally we call as camera, where we are going to capture the picture that we are going to transmit. That first camera tube is called as iconoscope. And the next one is 1935, when the TV broadcasting started. The year 1935, when the year broadcasting is started, and in the year 1959, the TV came to India. These are the some important general knowledge about the TV. Next, we move on to evolution of TV. This everybody knows. The evolution starts from black and white simple TV, which is having CRT tube. It is bigger in size, and next the color TV, which is also same, which is also using the CRT tube. Next comes the plasma TV, and later the HD TV, which is thinner in size. Next, because after plasma TV, the CRT is replaced with the 3D. Next, the last today we are going to use the TV technology, that is 3D TV. This is how the evolution of TV occurs. Next, some of the definition that we must know about a TV engineering are intensity of light. Let us start with the intensity of light. What do you mean by intensity of light? The intensity of illumination can vary from darkness to a light of bright. that is, we can compare it with a reference, that is a light of faint stars with a 0 decibel, that is faint stars is considered as a 0 decibel to a bright light, that is sun on snow. When the sunlight falls on the snow, it is considered as 110 decibel. We are going to take these two aspects as a darkness and lightness reference. So, the intensity is compared with these two darkness and brightness factors with the decibel 0 to 110 dB. The intensity of illumination can vary from darkness to light of bright. This is what the intensity of light in a picture says. Next is aspect ratio. We know that all the television will be of in width will be greater than the height, because the picture is made to be framed in the 4:3 ratio, that is what the general and standard form, that is called as a aspect ratio. Width to height ratio of picture frame is called as an aspect ratio. Width is always kept longer than height because there are some following factors. Why always the width is kept longer? Because eyes can move with more ease, comfort in horizontal direction than in the vertical plane. And also, horizontal dimension of a scene is generally more than its vertical. And third one, the fovea. The fovea of a retina means there is a depression bone in a eye. So, that depression makes the horizontal width in the retina part will be more than the height. So, the eye can read horizontally more than its height, that is why the aspect ratio kept always 4:3. As a result, we made all the picture frames should be in a ratio of 4:3. Next, we have a look on some examples regarding this aspect ratio. Dimension of a TV receiver are specified by the diagonal length of the screen. Okay, that is what, when we are going to buy a TV commonly in a shop, they mention the inches, the TV screen show always mentioned in inches, in 32 or like 21 or 50 like that. This size of a TV means it is diagonal size, its screen diagonal size, not its width or height. This screen will be measured in a diagonal way. So, here in the example they are given, when the width is 4x and height is 3x and diagonal would be 5x, this is a general thing. So, keeping this point in mind, we are going to use this point in a example. Determine height and width of a TV screen of 30 centimeter size. So, they mentioned the TV screen size, we know that 30 centimeter. And now, how can we determine the height and width? We know the aspect ratio, that is 4:3, it is standard for all TV system. So, we know that for 5x is equal to 30 centimeter, for 4x and 3x width and height, 5x will be the diagonal as we know from the point above. So, 5x is equal to 30 centimeter. Therefore, we can find out the x, x will be 6 centimeter, hence height is equal to 6:3. So, in the place of x, we are going to replace x with 6 centimeter, that is 18 centimeter height, and width is equal to 6:4, that is 24 centimeter. This is how we can able to determine height and width by knowing the screen size. Next is picture element. A picture element is used for analyzing and processing an image, and it can be considered it consisting of a very tiny dots, and it is also called as an individual element of a picture, also called pels or pixels. These are most important things we are going to use frequently throughout the session. Here in the picture, we can observe in the figure 1.1 pixels on a vertical line and on a horizontal line on a screen. It is an individual element of a picture, that is that represents pels or pixels. Here the arrow mark shows the pixels. This is a pixels in a vertical line. This is a pixels in a horizontal line. Next, the picture elements also represent the maximum number of pixels that can appear in a vertical line on the screen will be always equal to the number of vertical horizontal lines. So, the maximum number of pixels that can appear in the vertical line will be equal to the maximum horizontal lines. So, from the figure 1.1, we can easily observe there are 18 pixels in the vertical line, that is equal to 18 horizontal lines. So, number of pixels lying on the vertical line is equal to number of horizontal lines. That is, in the figure there are 18 horizontal lines. So, there are 18 pixels in the vertical line. As the aspect ratio is 4:3, there would be 18 × 4/3, that is 24 pixels in a horizontal line. So, we know the horizontal line pixels number. Now, we can able to calculate the total number of pixels in a frame. Total number of pixels on the screen would be 18 × 24. 18 will be the line, horizontal line, and into 24 means 18 horizontal line into 24 in each horizontal line. That gives a 432 pixels in the whole screen. This is how we can calculate the number of pixels in a screen. Next, details and resolution. Details means how in a screen the tiny, very fine particles, fine elements can be visible, and the resolution, the distinctly the small or features of a picture are distinctly visible. If we say the picture resolution is good, means we are able to see the very tiny particle in a distinct manner, then only we can say it has higher resolution. For example, if you are going to see some scenes on a TV, that we could recognize the veins of leaf or hair on or the veins of green or hair and eyebrow, all these are very tiny particles of in a picture. So, the resolution is very good, we are able to see all this tiny particle, fine particles very clearly. This is what the resolution means. The ability to see in the fine details in a picture is called resolution. Next, visual acuteness and viewing distance. How the human eye has a resolution of 1 minute, that is 1/60 degree. It means that if two closely spaced object form a minimum angle of 1 minute at the eye, they would be distinctly visible. So, minimum angle of degree is 1 minute. If two object is separated by 1 minute, means the eye can easily recognize the two objects separately. If the angle between two object is lesser than this 1 minute, what we can see is it is merged. We can able to see it as a merged object, not as a separate object. So, from this what are the angle subtended at the eye will depends on two factors. There are two factors that how this angle subtended by the eye will depend on. That is, one is the distance between two objects, that is S, the space or distance, the space S between the object and the distance D from which the object are being seen, that is S and D. Two factors, angle subtended the eye will depends on S and D. So, this is how in the picture we can easily find out the two objects. A and B is the object, E is eye, where we can able to see the A and B object through the eye subtended angle alpha. D is a distance between eye to B, and S is a distance between A and B. Let two closely spaced but distinct object be A and B. Angle alpha subtended by A and B at the eye is equal to, that is alpha is equal to S by D radians. So, radians we know that is equal to 180 divided by pi. We can convert radians into degrees. So, alpha is equal to 180 pi into S by D degrees. For clear resolution, this angle should be what we know, that is 1/60 degree is a for clear vision of A and B. So, we know that alpha is equal to 180 by pi S by D, that is equal to 1/60 for clear resolution. So, S by D is equal to pi by 180 × 60. So, from this expression we can easily calculate the distance between the angle I to the object and also space between the object. Next, we are going to apply this expression in some of the example. Calculate the minimum distance between adjacent pixels for the viewing distance equal to 2.5 meters. So, 2.5 meter here we consider this 2.5 meter is, we know that is distance D. We know D here. So, S is equal to 2.5 we substitute d in the expression. So, we get 73 into 10 power minus 5 meter, that is 0.073 centimeter. Same, keeping this value, we are going to do another example. Calculate the number of pixels in 50 centimeter size TV screen. So, we need to calculate the number of pixels, but we know here only the screen size, that is 50 centimeter. So, we know 50 centimeter screen size width or diagonal width. So, diagonal size, but width and height will be 4 and 3. 40 centimeter will be the width, height will be 30 centimeter. So, therefore, number of pixels in the width would be 40 divided by that already what we calculated, that is the distance, the space between the object. So, number of pixels in the width would be this, and the number of pixels in height would be 30 divided by 0.073. So, the total number of pixels in the entire screen would be multiplication of width and height pixels. So, multiplying both, we get 226,000 pixels in a screen. This is how we are going to calculate the number of pixels using the formula S by D is equal to pi by 180 degree into 60. Next, the important thing that the television technology is using, because they are able to see all the pictures in continuous manner because of the persistence of vision that we have, that is a nature gift for us. Because we know that for eye, we can able to see any object, a light or any object only for 1/60 milliseconds, okay. Even lesser than 60 milliseconds if we take out that object, but due to the persistence of vision, we are able to see the same object till 16 milliseconds. So, if you are in a light, if you are in a light room, a bright light room, if the light goes within 60 seconds, then what happens, even though the light will goes lesser than 60 milliseconds, we are able to see the light. Because it is an illusion of eye that it will assume that the light is still persist. When the eye sees light, it continues to see it for about 60 milliseconds after the light source is removed. Even though the light source is removed, we are assumed that eye will going to assume that the light will be there. This property of yours is called as persistence of vision. This is the technique that I am going to use in a TV technology. That is why if there is a gap between, there is lesser gap between each frame, when the one frame is come and the between next frame should come within this limit, so that it will going to merge and we can able to see as a continuous film. That is why it is, this technique is helpful in a TV technology. Next is flicker. This is an opposite of persistence, that is the time of persistence of vision is more for darkness. So, here we consider it is persistence is more for darkness than for bright light. So, it means dark intervals between the bright light picture, bright picture becomes visible for very short time, and very short times means the darker intervals between bright picture become visible for very short time, and this appears as a flicker for us. Next is a brightness. Brightness in the TV picture is the average intensity of light. This will determine the background level of illumination in a picture. The eye adapts itself to average prevailing brightness and sees all variation with respect to this adapted value. That is how the picture quality, the everything, that quality or clarity, the visibility, everything depends on these factors like brightness, the persistence, the color, the contrast. Everything will be controlled, that is we will study in the next upcoming session. Next we move on to the unit. Till now we studied the basics of television engineer, what we required for the further study of our subject. So, now we come to the actual syllabus, starts with the elements of a TV system. Today we are going to discuss only about the picture transmission. We are going to start with the picture transmission. The picture transmission fundamental aim is to extend the sense of eye beyond this nature limit. The eye can only visible up to 500 meters, 200 like that it can able to see, but not far than lakhs or crores, millions kilometer. It is not possible for an eye, because due to the picture transmission all these limits will be crossed, that is beyond the nature limit. We can able to see the pictures, which is far away from our eye. This is the fundamental aim of a picture transmission. In next is in 625 line monochrome system. This is a 625 line monochrome means monochrome in the sense single color, that is black and white, black and white TV system having 625 lines in each frames. So, this will going to for 620, what is 625 lines, everything we will discuss in the second chapter thoroughly, but for a basic we are going to move like this 620 lines, 625 lines will be in a single frame. It is a standard for transmitting analog signals from a CCIR, that is Consultative Committee for International Radio, standard lines for 625 line. And here the picture is transmitted with along with a sound signal also. We know that sound signals will be always modulated with the frequency, and the picture signal is always modulated with the amplitude, and carrier frequencies are suitably spaced and modulated outputs radiated through a common antenna. And both these pictures and the sound signal are modulated through the carrier signal, and these two will be combined in a combined circuit and outputted through a common antenna in the form of electromagnetic waves. Next, how the picture information will be? Always we know the picture information will be in optical in nature. Whatever the object we capture, that will be is of light, of optical in nature, and this we are going to arrange the darkness and dark brightness in a large number of dark and light brightness in a order manner. Each represent a picture element, and all this darkness and brightness give us a picture details. So, everything is important in a picture transmissions. So, the picture transmission is a very complex things than the sound transmission what we are, that is FM or everything that what previously using. Even though it is having complex, we need to carry all this complexity with a single channel. So, all this will be in a the complex waveform that what we get in a time and space variation, but all this will be converted to a variations of only in time with a technique called scanning. Information is a function of two variables, that is time and space. And now, all this instead of using number of channels for transmitting this information, we need to scan all the things at a time, and we are going to transmit element by element through a technique called scanning. What is scanning? Optical information is converted into electrical form and transmitted element by element, one at a time in a sequential manner to cover the entire scene to be televised. This is called as scanning, and this scanning is done at a fast rate, and it is done repeatedly because there are lot of frames will be there which has to be televised. So, this will be done in a very fast rate. And how it is done means it is simply less than how the written page has to be read out, and it includes all the words in a line, and also it covers all the lines in a page. So, it should not miss a single information. Next, the important things in a picture transmission is TV camera. This is a heart. The heart of TV camera is a camera tube. The camera tube, that is what and where we are going to capture the image, and this camera tube will going to finally outputs the video signal. The camera tube converts the optical information into corresponding electrical signal. Okay, and here the amplitude is proportional to brightness. Whatever the signal that we got, that having some amplitude, the variations of amplitude is depends on its brightness. Optical image is focused by a lens assembly to a rectangular glass face plates. All this camera tube will be having different lenses, different types of lenses to focus the image. Transparent conductive coating at the inner side of the glass face plate will be there. Transparent conducting face plate will be there. After that, on which a thin layer of photoconductive layer will be there. First will be conductive layer, and after that a thin layer of photoconductive material. This will be having very high resistance. When no light is fall on it, it is having very high resistance. The resistance go on decreasing when the intensity of light increases. So, when the light increases, the resistance decreases, and also the electron beam is used to pick up these images on the target plates in terms of varying resistance. So, what are the variations in the intensity made? If it is increased, the resistance is decreased, that is made in the target plate. This we need to pick up from a electron beam. The electron beam is formed by an electron gun. The beam is formed by electron gun, and this electron gun is used to carry the electron beam to the screen, and this deflected by a pair of deflection coils kept mutually. There is a pair of deflection coils at the corners which will going to deflect the beam, so that it will going to start from the left to right or top to bottom. All these things we discussed in a scanning topic very clearly, but in a brief I am going to explain the TV camera working. Kept from top to bottom, or it is going to deflect from top to bottom or left to right mutually, because there are two deflecting coils which is kept perpendicularly, so that the entire scene will be scanned. So, this is how TV camera will be. This is a light. This is a light that we are going to be focused by a focused lens. The object to be televised will be this with duty focusing lens. The light will be fall on a conductive coating, and after this there is a photoconductive surface will be there. Photoconductive surface will be having high resistance when there is no light falling on it. When the intensity of light varied due to the focusing the object, the resistance will be decreased. The resistance will be decreased, so that there will should be a some electron beam to pick up this electron. So, the electron gun will be used to form a electron beam here. This electron beam will carry to the electron gun. So, due to the variation the resistance, there will be a increase in current. So, increase in current means there obviously there will be a voltage variation. This signal is called as video signal, where the optical information is converted into electrical thing, and here the conductive coating is connected to RL, the load resistance, and the load resistance is connected to DC power supply. Next, already I said that each frame will be scanned from top to bottom, either from top to bottom and left to right, to cover entire screen, entire scene. It has from left it is tracing to right, and again this dotted line is called as retracing part, because it has to come back, the electron beam has to come back to its original position. From again it start from left, again it moves to right, that is called tracing part. This dark one is tracing and the dotted line is retracing part. This is how from top to bottom the scanning is done for a each frame in a camera tube. And what is the video signal means? We know that the video signal will be having a information of picture in an electrical signal. The video signal have electrical signal, that is information of a picture, that is having a picture information with it, that is called as a video signal. And this video signal is amplified. This video signal is amplified and amplitude modulated with the channel picture carrier frequency. There is some set of frequency to for every channel, that whatever channel that we are watching in a television, then all this channel will be having a different frequency, that is carrier frequency. So, when it is modulated to a particular frequency, we are going to send through a particular channel. So, when in the receiver part, if we are able to connect to the particular channel, we can able to set to a particular frequency, that frequency is set in, and that picture we are going to able to see in a receiver. And all this picture is fed to the, and all this information, that is when the amplitude is modulated and with the channel picture carrier frequency, and all these signals are fed to the same common output, that is antenna, and it is in the form of electromagnetic waves along with the sound signal. This is how physically the camera tube looks like. This is the front end part where the light is captured, and this is some of the lens, focusing lens. And finally, we come to an end of the session. that what are we discussed is the introduction part, that is what when the TV broadcasting is come is in the year of 1935, and with the aspect ratio, which is very important, that is 4:3 is the standard aspect ratio, and the dimension of a TV receiver is always specified by its diagonal length, and individual elements of a picture is called pels or pixels. And also we come across the working of a TV camera tube, how it is very necessary in a picture transmission system. Next, we are going to look for some of the questions, that is what is an aspect ratio, what is persistence of vision, what is scanning, why scanning is done at a faster rate, what is the basic principle operation of television camera tube. This ends the session. Thank you.